Hello, and welcome to another segment of Building an Andy Clancy Lazy Bee. How to cut out the windows. As simple as Andrew Clancy wanted to make this plane, the round windows remain a problem. I'll show you how simple they can be. Andy included a clever little tool in his instruction manual. It's a circle cutter. I'll show you how to construct one so that it really works. Let's get started. There are a few things that you'll need. A piece of 1/32 inch plywood, some sandpaper, half inch hobby ply, a sewing needle about 2 inches long, single edge razor blade, 3/8 wood screw, a razor saw, a pencil, and some thick CA glue. With these supplies, we'll construct our little circle cutter. I cut 2 pieces of the half inch plywood to size, added a little glue between them. I clamped them up. I allowed them to dry overnight. In the morning, I had a perfect little square to start our project. In the manual, Andy shows us that the wooden block needs to be notched to accommodate the razor blade spine. We scuff it up a little bit with some sandpaper so that the glue will adhere to it. It was positioned on the block and glued in place with some thick CA glue. It was then given time to cure thoroughly. The screw is aligned through the hole in the razor blade and into the wooden block. So now we have a firmly attached single-edge razor blade. Our next step is to attach the sewing needle to the wooden block for our pivot point. We've marked the location for the hole. Notice the 1/32 plywood attached to the bottom of the circle cutter. I have a drill press to drill the holes straight and accurate, but do the best you can if you don't have one. A drop of glue was placed in the hole. A bit more was put on the needle. The needle was then pressed into the hole with the glue. A drop of thick CA glue is dropped on top. And there you have it, the complete circle cutter with its pivot point needle. Andy calls for a scrap of 1/32 inch plywood to be glued to the area where the pivot point will be. After a few minutes, it's dry enough that I can press an awl into the center. With that done, we can now try to cut out a nice little circle. I placed the circle cutter in the pivot point hole and turned it around on the balsa. I found the circle cutter to be very difficult. It bound up on the balsa wood, especially on the cross grain, and it didn't seem to be making a very nice circle at all. I was extremely disappointed. I continued to cut with the little circle cutter, hoping it would improve, but it didn't. The circle was ragged, chipped. In theory, the circle cutter looked like it should be able to do this. There had to be a better way. And there is. I'm going to show you how to build the little circle cutter using a stationary pivot point. I begin this project with a scrap piece of wood. I drill the hole in it. A I cut a piece of 440 push rod and hammer that into the hole. The circle cutter gets a hole drilled in it large enough so that it turns smoothly around the stationary pivot point. A hole is drilled in our piece of balsa wood, tight enough so that it is snug around the pivot pin. We don't want it to move. The circle cutter is placed over that. I turn the circle cutter lightly over the balsa wood just to score it. I press down firmly to cut out the hole. The balsa hole just pops out. Nice, clean cut. Here's another look at it. Holes have been drilled in the balsa wood. That's placed over the stationary pivot point. The cutter put on top, and a few quick turns. Our window port's been cut out. All the side panels for our Lazy Bee, ready for construction. Enjoy. Please stop by RC Flyer US. You can get all the plans for the Lazy Bee, for the Speedy Bee, the Big Bee. All the plans are there. I hope you found the video informative and an easier way to cut out those tough little windows in the Lazy Bee.